from the first to the first. They count me out, yeah, yeah. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot, sizzling. Oh, don't count me out,
nah, nah.
It all begins
right here,
right now. Catch me if you can. Never really care what they say.
Oh God,
only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-chain, cha-chain, rackets, rackets.
Hit the bank,
ba-bang, ba-bang. Put you in your play. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
No, nope.
Ma, he got it rockin'. We bring havoc to your lobby.
Today, from Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, it's a special New Year's Day edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Cincinnati Bengals taking on the Washington football team.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. The enthusiasm of this Cincinnati crowd in full effect a moment ago as their Bengals took the field, to the delight of this sold-out crowd. And they're all set as they'll match up with the Washington football team. Two teams more than ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Cincinnati. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially. So a net gain of one there. Here come the Bengals now to take over. And a glance here at the man calling the plays under center, their 6'4 quarterback. They'll try and start this drive in the air. This goes out wide for Mixon. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. Three catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. Well, no slow start here. A couple nice chunk plays back to back.
I love the momentum that they're showing here early because they did it both ways, right? Threw the ball on first down for a nice chunk of yardage. Came right back and ran the ball. Looks like they've got the defense set back on their heels. Let's see if they can keep this moving.
And this one almost intercepted. Not a good throw there. Nearly an opening drive, INT. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. He goes right back to Higgins, and this time he's got him. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 41-yard line. So on the other side of the field now, it's first and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. A handoff to Mixon. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. They'll set up a throw. He finds his man complete. It's Ballard. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 30. So first and 10 now from the 30. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. And the catch made, it's Tyler Boyd. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number four in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
3 yards the gain there, second down. Again, he'll drop to throw. Yeah, he's got it. Well, he did everything but get him in the end zone there, but now they're set up. Golden opportunity, strong opening drive, and they're knocking on the door.
And the way that they did it, now look where they are on the field, all right? This is naturally set up for a running play, isn't it? But with this,
and he'll get him. touchdown. It's their quarterback keeping it himself from a yard out. And the Bengals take it right down and score on the opening drive. Looking sharp on that first drive. These guys, of course, coming off back-to-back victories. And you see that kind of advancing into this game, don't you?
You certainly do. And when you have a team that doesn't get too full of itself, even though they've won two games in a row, you get the end result that we saw there, that nice opening drive, because they're sharp, they're focused, and they're locked into everything that they're doing.
Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the made field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So out comes the Washington offense onto the field. As we take a peek at their versatile quarterback, the Hawaii native and former Oregon Duck, Marcus Mariota. First down, Mariota. Got an open man. It's Michael Gallup. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. The first carry for the Memphis man, Antonio Gibson. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. The numbers on the ground for Gibson a week ago. 19 carries, 64 yards.
And when he went over 1,000 yards last week, you know what it did for their offense? It gave them a true identity, because everyone's going to talk about this. The offensive line's going to take pride in it. Of course, the guy carrying the football will. But how about the coaching staff? When they go in to talk contracts, when they talk to reporters, hey, we had a 1,000-yard rusher this year. That means something in today's NFL.
And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now fourth down. So on fourth down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. Taken in at the 11. Call it a 48-yard punt. Give them 9, though, on the return. And the Bengals will take over here, first and 10. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. Now they'll be looking to duplicate the efforts of drive number one that resulted in 7 points in the 7-zip lead.
Well, you know how much I enjoy horse racing, right? Looks like they caught a flyer out of the gate, as they would say when you run in the big-time races. It means they get out to a fast start. They're setting the pace, making the other team chase now.
So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. The numbers for Mixon last week, 17 carries, 76 yards.
And well-liked by his teammates. In fact, I got on good authority, even though I'm not an investigative reporter, that in their team meeting this week, the offensive line stood up and said, "Coach, we've got to have better yardage for this guy. He's number 9 in the league. He's got to be in the top 3 before the season's over. Let's run the ball."
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy is setting the tone early, running through all types of tackles and putting the defense back on its heels.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. A big connection on that one. 31 yards. They lulled them to sleep there, so to speak. That was all set up by the running game, wasn't it?
Another example of what all offensive coordinators tell us. When the running game's operating, it really opens up the playbook. And that's when they hit them with the play action. And you can see the defenders rushing towards the line of scrimmage, then scrambling back, trying to cover. Couldn't get there in time.
Well scripted. They had the big running play, now the big passing play. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. They'll look to throw here. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Cameron Curl. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one.